Welcome back, everybody. So today is International Tiger Day. It's a day to raise awareness for tiger conservation. There's only 3,800 wild tigers left across the globe. They're on the brink of extinction. These beautiful animals. We have founder and director of Lions, Tigers, and Bears, Bobby Brink, joining us live from Alpine, along with rescue tigers Mocha and Nola. Good morning to all of you.
Good morning.
Oh, how beautiful. First of all, who are we looking at right here, Bobby?
So this is Mocha, and he's just sitting up there on his little ledge looking at me.
Oh, I
and I've got
it.
Nola down here with me, and she's kind of the boss, so she keeps him up there.
Oh, gotcha. She's like, hey, Mocha, you stay back. So, you know, you have this amazing sanctuary up in Alpine. Before we get into International Tiger Day and learn some interesting info about tigers, tell us about your big cat sanctuary. What do you have going on there?
So we actually have 65 rescued animals. We work all over the country with first responders to help get animals out of places where they shouldn't be and get them to sanctuary. Sometimes it's like the first time they've ever had medical. We'll provide a lifetime home, and we're an education center out here. So you can come out and visit and learn about all the different species of animals and how you can help.
Oh, and it looks amazing out there, and to be able to see these beautiful animals so close. Bobby, it's such important work you're doing, and Mocha and Nola are examples of that. Tell us about them and what brought them to your sanctuary.
So Mocha was the one you probably saw on, you know, all over the news, was coming across the border, and he was found on the floorboard of a car.
Wow.
And then Nola came from New Orleans. She was kept as a pet and abused, and then she was compensated by the authorities. So I'm going to try to get you to Nola. So we can see Nola over here. She's a little close to the fence, but
there's
this is Nola.
What a beauty.
So every animal here has their own story and where they came from. And Nola came as a baby. She was, when they picked her up, she was almost dead.
Wow.
And she couldn't make the trip here, so they took her to the local zoo, and they almost lost her a couple times, but they got her back. And then not only got her back, but got her healthy enough to travel here and do a 7,000-mile rescue with us.
Wow.
And then a little while later was when Mocha was caught on the floorboard of that car, and it was just the perfect timing that we could introduce these two to be lifetime companions.
Oh.
So they'll live out their life here at Lions, Tigers, and Bears.
I see. And, you know, to hear that these animals are on the brink of extinction, if you could, Bobby, tell us a little bit about that. Why has that happened?
Well, mostly human encroachment and poaching, lots of poaching. But what a lot of people don't know is there's more tigers in captivity in the United States than there are in the wild.
Mm.
So one of the things I beg people not to do is what we call the cub petting or the pay to play, because all it does is just increase the breeding. We know of businesses that breed 200 to 400 of these animals a year for nothing more than the cub petting, and they can only use them while they're babies, and then they're disposable. So the lucky ones like Nola here end up at a sanctuary. And we have no idea. There are no federal numbers of what happens to the rest of the tigers.
Oh, wow.
So we work really hard on legislation and to be their voice, working on the Big Cat and Public Safety Act right now to try to get that passed, which would stop that unnecessary breeding and stop that cycle of the pet mm-hmm. to play and get your photo taken. So please,
okay.
please don't do it.
Yeah, don't encourage that type of stuff. What you're feeding Nola right now, tell us a little bit, Bobby. Obviously, they eat a lot.
Right, so tigers are carnivores, so
yeah.
They eat raw meat with supplement. And so this is a little bit of pork, beef, and chicken. And Nola loves everything. I don't even know if she has a favorite.
She'll take any of the raw meat. Is Nola a white tiger then?
She is a white
okay.
tiger, and this is another thing that a lot of people
yeah.
don't know is 1 out of 10,000 in the wild, possibly. But the way we get white tigers in captivity is they inbreed.
Oh, no.
And they all have health issues, all the white tigers. And so another thing, you know, please don't do the pay to pet with the white tigers, because then they just breed more. And they have vision problems, metabolic bone disease. A lot of them die at birth or shortly after, and a lot of pain. So it's really hard with the white tigers.
I don't think many people know that. That's news to us here, Bobby, that white tigers are white because they were inbred. And as you're mentioning, I mean, so many health issues can come from that. So obviously we want to put an end to that. Tell us too, as well, as far as how we can support what you're doing at the sanctuary, and can people come visit your tigers that are there?
Right, so you can come and visit. You just get online, lionstigersandbears.org, and you can book your visit. And we do the visits Wednesday through Saturday. And you could also, you know, you get married here. You could do an event out here. You can come and volunteer. All kinds of ways you can help if you really want to help, and definitely can come out and learn a bit about the exotic animal trade.
Okay. Yeah, it's interesting what you're saying about the pay to play and pet. Those things cause more of the issues that you're seeing. And on this International Tiger Day, a great day to recognize that. Thank you for what you're doing to bring attention to it, Bobby. And thank you to Mocha and Nola for putting on that great show for us this morning. They really are beautiful creatures. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Have a great day. Happy International Tiger Day.